So what was the thing you wanted to open with?
That.
Oh.
Resident Evil ASMR.
Solid. All right. So anyways, this is what the gameplay looks like. This is what it's always looked like with fixed camera angles and weird movement sets.
Okay.
But this is a really weird, or it's really relatively new. It was remade for originally for the GameCube of the first game, but it expanded on several sections of the mansion.
Okay.
And so...
is this supposed to be the mansion above?
Yes, this is supposed to be the mansion that is in the first movie for like 20 minutes, okay, or 20 seconds.
So it didn't start down in the bottom, like...
no, it did not start in the hive. Okay, so now we're...
lame.
Gay. Oh, that was me. I'm super sorry.
I'm always goddamn telling you.
Y'all. All right. So let's load a game up.
Let's.
All right. I believe this is the one we'll want.
Great.
Because I've rotated the fuck out of saves, and I just happened to play Jill last on all of these. All right, so obviously we're not, I'm not going through invisible enemy nor real survival because it's a pain in the fucking ass.
I like how you say obviously, like I'm supposed to obviously know all
Yeah, you're supposed
time.
To obviously know that because fuck that. I did it. I'm done. I fucking got all the big dick energy. I've got a platinum on this, meaning I've gained every trophy for it. So, once again,
for those of you who haven't guessed it, John has a slight issue.
He has
a small addiction. It is the other woman in his relationship.
Hi.
No, Resident Evil. Oh, okay. You're the first woman.
Yeah.
This is the woman.
I thought I was the second.
This is the woman that he.
This came first.
He leaves you for. That doesn't mean that it.
All right. So, obviously, we're not playing. We're going to try to make this a simple playthrough.
Okay.
Resident Evil.
That's just menacing as fuck.
How long does this take to go through?
I've beaten the game in less than an hour.
No shit, huh?
Yeah. So, that being said, who do you want to play as?
Let's cycle through. Oh, there's only two people? Jill. Yeah, let's go with him.
You gonna go with Chris or Jill?
Chris.
I like Jill's outfits.
Alright. Well, here, we'll cycle through some outfits real fast. So here we have her military outfit.
Don't like it.
Her Resident Evil 3 costume.
That's pretty, completely impractical for
what
fighting.
What part of Resident Evil is practical?
Zombies. Well, I mean,
her first outfit looks pretty fucking practical. Kevlar shoulder pads.
I mean, that one looks, were I going to fight zombies, this is what I would pick.
Cannot stress this enough.
I feel like we should play it just because it's close to Valentine's Day and her last name is Valentine.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we can do this.
Cannot stress this enough, though. Resident Evil does have jiggle effects.
Jiggle, huh?
Jiggle effects.
Yeah, the jiggle.
When you walk, they bounce. We'll get a full detail of that in a second.
Super veto the tube top, then.
All right, so this is her Resident Evil 3 outfit, and then this is her Resident Evil 5, which is also, you can tell that it goes from her stars to BSAA.
I still think that one.
We're just going to play with the original?
Yeah.
All right.
He's like scary.
In case you didn't know, John is a fat piece of shit.
Alpha team is flying around.
Alright, you need to pay attention. This is important information.
Raccoon City, where we are searching for the helicopter of our compatriots, Bravo Team, who disappeared during the middle of their mission.
Have you found it yet?
No, not yet, Brad.
Bizarre murder cases have recently occurred in Raccoon City. There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people. Victims were apparently eaten. The Bravo team was sent in to investigate, but we lost contact.
Look, Chris!
Which, Bravo before you go, I want to show you the original opening, because it was all live action, and it was super fucking terrible.
Okay.
Safe from the remaining body. Also, Resident Evil fans will be excited to know, I'll put a picture up while I'm explaining this, that my shirt that I'm wearing tonight is a Jill Sandwich t-shirt.
We continued our search for the other
which
members.
Is prevalent to this game.
Okay.
If you need to know what that looks like, please Google it.
A nightmare.
It's so sinister.
You're sinister.
He's also got that shoulder mount camera, which is something I would like to incorporate for lunch break.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. For like the lunch vlogs.
Mm-hmm.
Look behind you. Always look behind you. They don't go that fast. Was that a creature?
Oh, you'll see what it is.
Oh, so it's like the dogs.
She completely froze. Bitch, move. That face when you can see, oh shit.
Come on!
Y'all better run. That was one of the grossest parts of the movie.
Hey, rat!
Just fucking left their asses.
Chris, this way.
It's still fucking cheesy, don't get me wrong.
How many? Okay, when they started this little scene with the dog, there were four.
And then
where the fuck did they come from? Yeah.
That's a really fun question, because they hunt in packs, and apparently, according to the novel, the others were stalking them the entire time, and after the first four went and tore Joseph apart, which is the dude with the bandana,
yeah.
As they're running through the forest, they just appear out of nowhere. Barry and myself, we don't know where Chris is.
Huh?
Do you...
What is this place?
Also,
not quite your ordinary house.
I would model my sure. fucking house after this place.
That would give Where's Chris? Me nightmares.
Exactly.
Jill, no.
Especially when you find out you how fun this house is.
But we've got
if
to
it's
find
anything like the museum.
What was that? Chris?
From RE2. Then
no.
I'm not interested.
Jill, go and investigate.
It's worse.
You gonna...
I'm going with her.
That's what I told him we'll never leave
Chris
him
and I
places.
Go back a long way.
There's right. a chief.
You know, in the movie, it was I'll a very this nice area. House.
It is a very nice house, but I don't want any of this shit going up.
It's very gaudy.
Oh, dude, super. A pharmaceutical company fucking just wrecked this place.
But they do everything else.
Uh-huh.
That dude's gonna get at, isn't he?
A dining room.
Also, my video game that I play, I've been making, I actually got writer's block and modeled this mansion after, or redid their mansion in my game.
Right.
Alright, so prevalent oh shit, I forgot!
What?
Equip that, we're dumping this off. This is the infinite rocket launcher. We will have no issues fighting anything if I used it, because we'd kill everything in one hit. Alright, anyways. Okay. So, first and foremost, like Resident Evil 2, this is the start of it. You need ink ribbons to save.
Okay.
I think you'd better take a look at this.
What is it?
It's blood. Don't what? Taste it.
He sniffed it.
Is he gonna Jill, say it's already cold?
See if you can find any other clues. I'll be examining this.
In the book, they
just
do.
Just hope it's not Chris's.
Just hope it's not Chris's. How do you lose him? He was literally right fucking behind y'all.
He's gonna die.
He walked in with you.
Barry.
No, Chris didn't.
Where's the other guy?
Who's Chris?
Chris was the dude who saved Jill. And
I thought that was that dude.
Yeah, I thought there was another dude with them. It said there's
yeah,
only
because when they walked into the building, there was three.
There were three of them.
Barry is examining the bloodstains.
When they walked into the mansion, there was always three.
Amino comprende.
No, pay attention.
I found a flaw in the game.
Whatever.
Numero one.
All right.
The biggest flaw of them all. Things can go through windows very fast.
Ew.
Yeah, this is one of the most iconic scenes in the freaking game, and it just makes me happy.
Yuck.
And thank you for coming to our TED Talk. We're out.
Yeah.
Barry.
So
what is it?
I'll tell you. You can fight him, but even if you do kill him, he still comes through the door.
Let me take care of it.
That's annoying.
You would think the size of that gun and how many shots he put into him, it would have like blown him backwards.
What the hell is this thing?
I found Kenneth
or
killed
part.
By this
yeah.
thing. Let's report this to Wesker.
Oops, sorry. Still trying to get used to the controls. Alright. So we're gonna piece the fuck out. There's the typewriter. And apparently he pieced out.
I like the door animation, but I will say the fixed camera view is really hard.
Wesker!
You know, I have a thing for just
Jill,
3D platformers.
Let's not leave this hall.
And there's nothing
Good
wrong
idea.
With that. I really like the fixed camera angle just because you can't survey the entire room by spinning. You actually have to move out of your comfort zone and look.
I definitely see the...
Fuck! Alright, tank controls are failing me, I'm sorry.
This is just weird because he's played this.
You can't
so
just
times.
Say fuck out of nowhere when we're playing a scary game, bro.
You can't
you
censor
all
right. that.
So another cool thing for speedrunning is when you're running down the stairs, instead of doing that and going, you just glide by mashing the run. And it's like,
Jill.
No, nothing. What's going on around here? I can't figure it out.
Same here.
Chris and now Wesker.
There's not much we can do.
Find Wesker.
Can search for him
so, does that name Wesker bring up anything?
No.
Like a whisper? Okay, then
remember
I'll
when I put the download code in for RE2 and then we got the 15-round handgun for Claire? And then it says Wesker Samurai Edge?
Okay.
I didn't see that.
You didn't see that? Oh, dude, yeah.
It's a lock. Damn it.
Wait, I thought we were supposed to be playing RE2, not RE1.
No, we're playing RE1. This is gonna be ours since Josh and I have...
So on a different... Thanks. We will be playing RE2 a different day.
Right.
If something happens.
Stay tuned.
Let's meet up in
this hall. We'll often do that when Josh is here.
Got it?
Okay.
Rayven is not a fan of the Resident Evils, or the Residents of Evil. I am. So, alright.
Residents of Evil.
Yeah.
That's funny.
That's a YouTube channel that you should all go check out. He's pretty solid. Alright, anyways. Barry was gracious enough to give us a big dick lockpick.
Oh, nice.
A tool for unlocking most simple locks.
Yes, he did.
Oh, dude, I saw everything. Alright. You can find defensive items, tasers, and knives.
Owie, that was my elbow.
That's some prime ASMR there, champ.
Injury number one.
Just put a counter. Injury number one. Alright, so it's been a while since I played this, ever since, I think the last time I played it was March of 2018.
No.
Yeah, that's the last known trophy I've gotten, and that's the last time I ever actually played it. So, first off, move that. Alright. Now, this is our first defensive item, which is a dagger, and I think I have it set to automatic, but I'll be mashing L2 to activate it if I get grabbed.
Huh.
She falls down a lot. Alright, let's see if I can bait him. Let's see if I can do it. Come on. Oh shit, no. Alright, well, failed that one completely, but we will save ourselves. Nope. There, now we can't get out. Emblem of a sword is carved on the lock. Alright.
This is upsetting, the music.
It'll go back to normal once we... So, I remember where to go. We will have to go visit an old friend.
Oh.
Yeah. That sucks. I probably shouldn't have picked up those ink ribbons just yet, because those are precious save slot or space. Just like Resident Evil 2, you have a limited amount of space that you can pick up actual items. And here. Just chilling out.
Who was that?
That was... You hear it?
Ew.
Looks like he's holding something. In the original game, you could investigate his body twice and find two...
Whoops, my bad.
And find two rounds, or two magazines of ammunition.
I cannot stress this enough. When you're in a house that has zombies, you need it to be well lit. You cannot afford to be mistaking some moving shadows for enemies. It's life or death. You really just gotta turn on the goddamn light.
Lights everywhere.
Look, we know... Okay.
Can I get a little herby?
I really hate this fucking section.
Okay, well... Ah! It's scary.
Alright, so now we gotta come over here, grab the old golden arrow, which holds, and that's just gonna tell us how to examine shit. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit! That'll just tell us how to examine shit. Alright, so now, I want to know if I can do it, if I can get him.
Oh shit,
nice. Nope. Nope, that was my key.
Oh my god, oh my god. Oh,
alright, alright, we're good, we're good, we're good. Dude, get off.
Right, no means no.
I mean, that's not a laughing matter, that is true. No means no.
Right, but it sounded, also
that,
means...
That sounded insensitive when I giggled and you were like, Is it just me up here?
You know how every universe has its own rules? I will say this. The zombie rules of Resident Evil make more sense to me than the zombie rules of any other zombie universe.
What do you mean?
How they're kind of clumsy and slow and stuff.
Versus... Rather than like the running and I'm gonna get you thing.
Yeah, like the Brad Pitt movie.
Oh, yeah,
you know,
World War Z.
They were so ridiculous in that one. They were absolutely ridiculous.
You need to heal.
I did not grab any healing items.
I find zombies.
Yeah, which I told you to grab the plant, but you didn't.
I'm actually probably going to take that up on you, so let's go grab an herb.
Take that up on you?
Yeah. Let's go grab an herb. Actually, you know what? If I die, I can get us back here with no issue, but let's go ahead and equip this real fast. And I know I said I wouldn't, but this is just going to ruin the playthrough.
Is she injured?
Yeah.
Just to do that.
Just for fun. Sure.
Just to show you that animation, which is like not many people go and investigate the original door that you ran away from the danger from.
Yeah. Because there's...
Because you know what's out there. And so when I did it, I was a scared little baby.
Why did nobody stop that clock from TikToking?
Because it's just doing this thing, girl.
I cannot abide the TikToking.
I can't abide TikTok, the application on the phone, but hey,
Also, Zombieland has the best rules, which is double tap.
Has the best zombie rules, but again, they're not slow and clumsy like they're supposed to be.
Cardio, dude. Double tap.
I take one.
Enjoy the small things in life, too. That is a very big one. That's just important now. Okay, so now we're no longer dying. I believe...
That's a funny thing to say.
What?
He said, enjoy the small things, do it now. When I said cardio and double tap.
And that's how you make babies. So I think it's in the harder difficulty that there's nothing in here, but up on that ledge up top, there would be crows.
Hence live the crows?
Live crows. And it's always a fun thing that if you startle them, they attack you.
Yeah.
They are in one of the Resident Evil movies, though, also, right?
Yeah, they're in the third one, I believe. Extinction.
They, like, attack a bus.
Yeah, that's the third one. Out in the desert?
Yeah.
Or in the middle of Las Vegas?
I don't think I actually watched that one, but I did see that part.
The Resident Evil 1 and 2 movies, I really loved. And then... the first one, not so much.
I
the
like Silent Hill.
The second one, the first Silent Hill, fantastic. The second one, they tried to copy the third game too much, and it just kind of ruined it. I feel like it was forced. The first Resident Evil movie was okay. I mean, like, yeah, it was probably one of my favorites just because it was a video game kind of come to life for me, but it didn't follow what you see now. Also...
Is this going down to the hive?
No, actually it's not. But we're gonna bitch out and not attack anybody. So anyways, we got our item. Now
I don't like the hearing them breathing.
Oh dude, yeah, it's super bad.
Okay, so now we're going down to the hive, yes?
No, the hive is actually just doesn't exist.
Oh.
Mm-mm, no.
So what is the story in this of how it originated?
Of how this are all originated?
Yeah, like the zombies.
Do you want me to tell you, or do you want me to let you find out as we play through?
Oh, okay, I guess we'll find out.
Okay. Book of Curses sounds like what it is, but it's not.
Fuck.
You just can't say fuck in a scary game.
You have to have the Book of Curses.
Well, it's better than the Book of the Dead from The Mummy.
Yeah,
I mean, that made me jump.
That's scary. That was scary.
The lights went out, and there's no lights in here. There's no motion sensors. So now yeah. We're in complete darkness, and now I'm paranoid that where I'm sitting, a Zambambo will come and get me. And
Zambambo,
yeah. So if I had my knife, this would be a lot simpler. Because then I could just sit here and stab their legs.
Right. I like how he turned around and walked away, though. He was like, oh, this is lights. Ah! Oh my god!
Oh, there he is. He's up. No, I don't need it. I don't need it. I'm good. You play too much.
I don't like the dark.
Alright, so... Where were we at? You were asking about... Oh. There we go.
Yeah, bullets.
Yeah, one shot is... You know, I really can't say one shot won't kill me. Because one shot will fucking kill me. One shot is the...
Oh, don't go in there.
One.
That is pretty effing ominous.
And when that caption, I wonder what's on that side of the door. That is the mind your fucking business. Whatever's on that side of the door can stay on that side
mind
of the door.
Mind business.
Alright. So, examine. If you examine things, and
okay,
then...
Okay, it's got the sword on it.
Yep, it'll now replace it with the sword key. Now, we
instead
don't...
Instead of mansion key.
Yeah, instead of mansion key. So, I don't think we're gonna need the entire...
That thing was moved since...
It defaults back to its position.
Alright. I'm about to say it's gonna play some tricky tricks.
Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of upset that I don't have my knife for what I'm trying to do here right now all of a sudden, but we're gonna...
Yeah, the whole not taking your knife out of your Zambambo's head is pretty silly. You should be able to do that. By nature, knives are reusable weapons.
Apparently fucking not in Resident Evil 2. I lost my knife in the fat guy and I'm...
What did you just do?
I didn't do shit. And do you like this hallway?
I mean, there's a lot of china cabinets.
In the original game, they were filled with bones.
Ew.
Yeah.
See, that's a silly thing because, you know how long it takes for bodies to rot into skeletons.
Mm-hmm. Or you could have a whole facility trained to flay the flesh off of bones and then put them on display. All right.
Which is so awesome, because I've watched that documentary.
Here we are. Perfect, perfect display. Jiggle effect.
Oh, wow. Do that again. My jiggle, goodness.
Jiggle, jiggle, jiggle.
That is a lot of jiggle.
Jiggle, jiggle, jiggle. Alright, I don't...
It's like a flashback.
Hey, I have an online game I play that's called Terra, and my elf literally jiggles as she walks. It's funny.
You know,
that's reality.
Change the jiggle effect, actually.
Woof, woof. Yeah, alright, so we need this chemical to use on plants. I like how they have to specify chemical to use on plants. Fuck no. The reason I say that, and I'm sorry for just yelling fuck no in the panic, is because it's a trigger, and if you go too far, dogs, I think three of them, jump over the fence and then just fuck my shit up. Okay. So instead of wasting the bullets...
Right, right, right.
We'll also try to get as many of the weapons, because why not?
Ew. No.
Let's remove the plug.
It's gonna be a body. Yeah, I knew it. Although I wouldn't be upset to die in the bathtub. I do quite like going to that.
We had that happen to the zombie that just went over the railing.
Did she just squash his head?
Yeah.
That's grabbing at our feet.
That was a really weak attempt of a throw up.
Yeah.
Alright. So that's all I wanted it for. I'm trying to get as many defense weapons because, as you see, I'm terrible at not getting hit.
Yeah.
And
it's always been this way.
There's a really fun there's a really fun thing in this game that I'm not gonna be... How do I want to put this?
You don't
Without spoiling it.
You talking about the glass windows?
Spoil.
No.
Okay.
That hallway where the window chipped, we're never going back in there.
Are there zombies in there now?
No. Nope. I will tell you that dogs jump out and it just makes it super stressful.
Okay. I'm not sad to not deal with the dogs.
Sorry.
So
that'll be smart.
Let's see if I remember how to do
this. Did that painting just move?
No, it didn't. It's just the angle.
Okay.
I
don't got no time for no moving paintings. This isn't Scooby-Doo.
This is like Scooby-Doo after dark.
Yeah, this is... I mean, it is pretty Scooby-Doo.
So, in the original...
Oh. Oh god, what did I do now?
Wesker!
Barry! Help!
Why are you calling for Wesker? Is he
Jill!
Dead?
You in there?
Barry? Get me out of here! The door's jammed!
Stand back!
Not really much where I can stand, Bear.
Grab my hand!
Why did he pause for like a split fucking second?
Why did she not move at all? The amount of self-preservation.
Oh, and when you go through the door, it shows you like sliding across the ground. Sorry, I just wanted to point that out. Anyways, you were saying?
The amount of self-preservation that these people have is terrible.
Agreed.
Barry,
Jill, that quit freezing.
Quit being a wiener.
When you all gotta be shooting your guns and shit.
Really? Thanks.
But Barry, didn't really you say you were going back to the dining room to find other
yes,
clues?
Yes, that is exactly
I'm
true. So
all,
during this,
he
Barry exclaims, he's like, that was
I
close.
Just had something I
you
wanted
were
to
almost
check.
A Jill sandwich.
Anyway,
and it's just really
we should
awkward.
Get back to searching for Wesker and Chris.
And...
Thanks, Barry. I owe you one.
Don't trust Barry. I feel like Barry's a bad guy. Barry is the guy. Yeah, that's true. But I feel like Barry's gonna feed her to the zombies.
Look at you being philosophical as fuck. We're all bad this way.
Everyone's got a bad side.
Ain't that the fucking truth? All right.
I was good until I met John.
Bow chicka bow wow.
Yeah, that was like the opening to y'all's porn.
Probably.
Let's see if I can get let's see if I can get around this cat. Zombies do in fact go. Nope. Ah, you gross.
Just not.
Oh, he threw up on me.
Yeah.
Hello,
now
we'll get back
to
me. I just need to get through here. Alright.
I bet you zombie puke stinks.
They describe it in the novels of the first game as just complete bile that's so acidic coming in contact would burn you.
That's gross.
As much as I want to put the ultimate handgun in my inventory that gives me a chance of headshots, we won't because I'm a team player. We're gonna dump that. We're gonna probably dump this. Let's see, is there anything else we can take for the time being? No, I think. Sorry, this is gonna annoy me. There we go. The closet key just allows us to swap into different costumes and stuff like that later on. Alright.
What's that?
Oh, this? It is a canteen. Around the mansion, you will find gas cans and stuff like that for the disposals of dead bodies. We have new information regarding those beings that may appear to be dead, but are in fact they're able to come back to life. However, there are ways to prevent them coming back active again. Currently, there are two known methods to cease their resurrection: incineration and destruction of the head.
See, this is something that I also like about these. The destruction of the zombies is pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
A lot of other zombie universes are not.
Like.
As concise.
How do we stop these things? And they're like, has no one tried shooting one of these things in the head?
Or it's like,
that's my first go-to. I'm gonna shoot you in the head.
Yeah.
Can't bitch about that. Resident Evil 2. I screamed, I'll shoot it in the head, and then it kept coming, and I was like, fuck, we need to run.
Yeah, you. I think that they're. I mean, I know that that's not how life works, but zombie universes should work like that.
Should.
Meanwhile, to those of you who still have the will to live, oil has been placed on the first floor of the mansion. Take as much as you need. You'll need something to light it with, which you'll need to find by yourself. So basically, they just gave you the big old fuck you. We will try not to kill as many zombies, because we won't kill what we don't need to. I would like to do my best of... Where'd it go? Oh, okay, well, it's gone.
No,
it ain't. Oh no, I killed it. Oh shit.
I'm not gonna lie, but he just scared the shit out of me.
Oh fuck!
Whoa.
Not him.
Ooh.
Him. See, walked by.
Oh, okay.
Wow, that was a one hit kill.
That, no. Just knocked him down. I will take it. Alright. So, after being a little baby bitch.
He walked by and scared the
shit. It's just spoopy. Oh! Shit!
Ooh, he lunged. Ooh. Who are you fighting, zombie? Oh
Holy
my
man.
God.
Alright, are we wanting the best ending, the okay ending,
the worst one,
or the
scared.
Worst ending? I can
I
give you the worst.
I want the worst ending.
You want the worst
I
ending?
I want you to die.
A crumpled memo. Today, Sir Spencer told me to hide something where no one could find it. Well, I had this idea. I figured if I could somehow have it protected by a dangerous animal like the vicious canine that lives here, no one would be able to get near it. As far as I can tell, the mutt is always hanging around the second floor balcony on the west side of the terrace, and he ought to come running at the sound of this dog whistle. But this is where you come in. The thing is, I reckon you're the only person that can get near the damn dog without risking a serious mauling. Which means only you can put this collar on him. The objects that Sir Spencer wants hidden is concealed inside. You're the only person I can trust with this. Of course, you'll get something out of it as well. Remember us, that certain item that you've always wanted to get a hold of. God damn, that trips me up so bad.
Yeah, that's a hard sentence.
In exchange for your services, I just might be able to get it for you. This could work out for the both of us. Jon Tolman.
Who is Jon?
He's just apparently a resident of this mansion who was to work here. So we are doing really well right now. We've got a lot of ammo. I'm not going back through this. The botany book just explains that's the lighter to light the bodies on fire. Don't need it, really. Anyways, the botany book explains green herbs are medicinal, red herbs have no effect on their own, blue herbs cure poison. I don't like that RNG. Let's try it again.
You don't like what?
RNG, random number generated, and it kind of just randomly places the zombie wherever. He could be facing me, facing away from me. It gives me a better chance. Nope. Oh, fuck. I forgot certain doors can be opened up by Zambambos. Fucking hell, this is hard. Oh shit, oh fuck. And this is why I hate using the alternative controls, because I can't get... Okay. It's been a while.
This is stressful.
Barry.
Jill, got any good news?
Other than I'm still alive in this madhouse? No.
No.
Can't say it's much safer here either. We'd better secure our escape route first. There's gotta be a back door somewhere.
All right then, let's split up again.
Hey, hold on a sec.
It's like the whitest thing ever. Let's split up, gang.
What?
Fuck no.
A can of fizz. It's sure to yellow and mellow those things. It's yours. Hopefully you won't have to use it.
Acid gels.
What does that do?
They are extremely powerful shells that shoot acid.
I like the buddy system we
have. And like burn their bodies?
I see.
Kills them in one hit, basically.
Thanks. Okay.
Until you get later on in the game.
Ciao.
I super don't trust that guy. I think he's bad.
That's fair.
Because he is.
He looks fishy as fuck.
Yeah.
But he's not a bad guy.
No, don't believe it.
Okay. Alright. So now we are trying to... Oh, crap.
What did you do?
I forgot. So completing the game once with Jill and once with Chris activates a thing in this game called One Dangerous Zombie. And it's a zombie with a bandolier of grenades. And if you shoot him, the entire house explodes and the game's over. And I can't figure out what side he was coming from, and nor did I want to figure it out.
But he was coming from the left side, right?
Yeah, but he might be coming from the right side. So now we just have to... Yeah,
He's running, too.
Dude, yeah, he is hauling ass. We don't... He won't play nice.
Huh.
Lockpick out and pick this door. The original Resident Evil didn't have this room.
How many hours did you put into the original?
Considering I couldn't get past one part in the game, I probably sank about 48 hours solid in my first time playing Resident Evil. As a kid, and then as an adult, I probably sank about 100 hours into it altogether.
How old were you when you first played it?
I was in fourth grade, I think. Wow. I was like 8.
Did you not have nightmares?
I had all the nightmares. So we're on the terrace where they were talking about it. We blew the dog whistle. fuck, I missed! Come on, get up! Oh, crap.
Shit, dude, shit. Oh, you got them both.
Oh, I did. Sweet. Okay, so they're dead. We are going to abuse these. There's only enough for a few uses, yeah. And I completely fucked up that first use. We also need to examine this collar. Press the button. And boop, out boys a coin. But we're not done yet, kids. Bam, a faux armor key. What could we need a fake armor key for?
Fake armor. No? Is that not?
I mean, fair. Wait, did I get rid of it? Okay, sweet. We're on the right track.
What, the collar?
Bless you.
Gross.
Thought he was gonna grab my feetsies. Alright, so now. Ooh, a bed. A well used bed.
Gross. I don't know what that means.
Let's take a time to abuse this, and we're going to. I don't know if I need this key anymore, but we'll keep it. Let's go ahead and dump the acid rounds. We'll dump the shotgun from Meow, and we'll keep everything else. We'll also fucking forget the steam ribbons, apparently.
Okay.
Yeah, I see what you're doing here. I also sank so many hours into Resident Evil, both the original and this remake, because the goal was to get all the secret costumes and stuff like that, was to beat the game in under 3 hours without saving.
Good lord.
And I struggled, as you can see. Okay. Well, I don't need to transfer the data. We're good. It'll just... Must save... Oh, I must save again? What?
To upload your data.
Well, does it save to the... Okay, it's saved. We're good. Return to the game without saving. Then it can be super salty if it didn't save. Let us save because we weren't connected to the internet. Alright. So now, let's continue our adventures of horror.
Yay!
Like a fire zombie.
Fuck that Zambambo. Dummy.
Stupid.
Oh. Lockpick, that's the door I was looking for. So, I'm blanking of where I need to do- Oh, I remember where I need to go. Okay. So that room that we almost got squished in?
Yeah.
That was the fake shotgun. So you would have taken that shotgun, and then ran back up to the room, took the shotgun off the wall, put that broken shotgun back onto the wall, and it would have negated that trap and that cutscene. There's also another oil and more fucking ink ribbon, which in the original, I think it gave us shotgun shells? Someone correct me on that in the comments, if anybody ever watches this.
If anybody ever watches this.
If anybody ever watches
this. I mean, we do have like 15 subscribers.
15
we are
beautiful
subscribers. Rolling in subscribers.
I am not going to be able to complete that, so we'll just have to bait him all the way over here. Haha. Loser. You wish you had
stupid
this.
Stupid. Stupid. Zombie. Touch on
Katie. All right. So who wants to bet that the zombie is going to be right outside the door and is going to fuck our playthrough up?
Okay.
God damn it!
Run! He's running down!
Oh lord, he's coming!
Oh lord! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh, oh fuck, oh fuck!
You're gonna have to make another loop.
Fuck no, this is the door I needed.
That's the same door you just came out of.
No, it's a different door.
Is there a reason you're just wasting bullets?
That!
You should know 3 doesn't do anything.
Okay. We won't be coming back down this hallway for a while, so I'm going to...
That's a good hit.
Alright, cool!
You were farther away.
So these things, when you kill a zombie, their bodies have stayed, as you can tell.
Unless you kill their head.
No. Well, I mean, yes. Sorry.
Yeah, don't tell her, no.
The worst thing about it is if you give them enough time, their skin tone changes, and it changes to like a crimson red, and then they get up and they have like these elongated fingers that have claws and they run.
Oh, they turn into something else.
And they're a lot... Oh, yeah, that inscription's beautiful, by the way. Death is the true essence of bliss, which I should probably get that tattooed on my body if I want to be depressed as fuck. All
right. Okay, so the mirrors in the hallways are to help you see down the hallways, correct?
Mm-hmm. They're helping you to see what enemy lie awaits.
Who put those there?
Nobody knows. It was just a design. A design of whomstever.
So all of a sudden they were just super prepared to have the zombies roaming the hallways.
Oh shit. So for the longest time, and this is what we need the faux key for. Imitation of key, use. The longest time, the person who is responsible for the outbreak chilled out here, researching it. And then when the outbreak occurred, and if we are fast enough, yep, we saw the shield. I also found that if you're fast enough and you try to touch it, it will damage you.
Oh.
And it hurts.
Interesting.
So he chilled out here, but he also designed the house and has specific... Specific designs. Alright, let's see if I can do it. Oh, fuck!
He's mad.
Oh, yeah, he's coming. Oh, shit.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, and his buddy's just chilling up.
Is that what he turns into?
Yeah, that's what they'll turn into unless you burn their bodies. And then once... Did he just leave?
Oh no, I'm sure he's coming.
I don't hear another clanking. Fuck it. Alright. So, we'll go ahead and force the statue off because this has a jewel and the jewel itself gives us a neat little prize at the end.
Cool.
Resident Evil is also one of the reasons why I like classical music, is because in this they use one of Beethoven's pieces, and it makes me happy. Because
it's weird that this makes you happy.
Yeah. No, the classical music piece that they use. Like, it was the first time I had ever heard anything.
It's weird that anything you associate with this game makes you happy. There's zombies gonna come out of there, huh?
Yep.
I'm not sticking around to find out. Fuck yeah, I got the mansion key. Which is the armor key. Taser.
See any herbs out of ground?
I try not to have to consume a item slot just because there's so much to do.
Yeah, but you're hurt. That's what I'm saying.
Am I hurt?
Yes.
I thought I
healed. You got attacked by the thing.
Oh, the Crimson Head. Yeah, you're right. I forgot about that. Alright, so we'll come over here and... I better not. We'll grab the emblem first. Oh, I shouldn't have grabbed it. Fuck.
The hell are you doing, man?
Fucking up the playthrough. Dicks out on stream. Everybody's gonna... Or, dicks out on the video. Everybody saw it.
Get your shit together, man.
You're asking an awful lot there, Mom. That's new.
Should that be there?
Oh, there we go. That's what I was looking for, at the edge of the bed. I'm not going to investigate that closet because I don't have time nor the patience to deal with the fuckery that is in there.
Sure, sure.
All it is at the end of it, you get shotgun shells.
Okay.
And then you would come in this side, little side room and put fucking the blue diamond. Oh, yeah, there's the Zambo in the window. You see his shadow on the wall?
Uh-uh.
Look to the right.
Oh, I do see it. Interesting.
Hi, could you please let me in? Alright, so anyways. Oh, man. Let's see if I remember the correct...
I'm sorry, but the guy who had so much forethought to design this mansion and everything, he made it very penetrable, number one, yes, and unnecessarily intricate.
So, here's...
And just very rundown. He's a very poor planner, is what I'm trying to say. If I was his mother, I would yell at him.
All right, if I fuck up, I fuck up for good.
Okay.
Nope, we're good. If you turn it on green, it sprinkles the green herbs and turns them all red, which turns them useless.
Oh,
and I can't heal myself. Alright, so I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going, and we just surpassed it. We're good. Everybody laughs uncomfortably.
I mean...
Alright.
We've all been curious enough to
well,
look at
the
hentai.
I guess we're all admitting it.
The help is okay for some reason.
If you think it's funny, it's because you watched it.
Oh, yeah.
Where?
So this is just herbs all over the place, huh?
Oh, yeah, dude.
Okay.
Completely. So now I'm completely full of health. I've maxed out. But I've also got one gigantic herb that looks like a joint, unrolled. That reminds me of the stupid ant carrying the joint. That makes me laugh.
You need to put that in here.
But right now, I don't feel like fucking with any of this. I'm just gonna bitch out.
I think bitching out is just fine.
I think it's the smart move.
I think there's something here.
I'm a big fan of bitching out, personally.
Oh, hi. I don't really... another thing to note in the novel is...
Hey.
Watch what?
I was really hoping it would be the other door.
Huh?
I was really hoping it was going to be the other door. You'd fuck up.
Oh, and the zombie would get me?
Yeah.
In the novel, they talk about the smell in the mansion and how nauseating it is. And I think at one point in time, Chris... comments about how he wants to yak because it's just gross. First off, oh fuck, it's a helmet. Alright, well, I can't use that key.
And of course, it's storming. Of course.
Oh, dude, yeah, it's the
epitome.
It's the perfect storm. It's such a shitty pun.
Oh, I really like how he designed this mansion, and he's like, how can I make this as creepy as possible? Let me get an artist and we'll make some zombie art to hang on the walls.
So that's another thing is I forgot to mention, because all right, so remember the zombie that was chasing us with the grenades?
Yeah.
He's fucking gone.
Don't trust that now.
Let's see if the real kicker is. So if the zombie with grenades, he's sitting right here next to the bazooka, and if you don't trigger the ceiling fall where Barry pulls us out, he'll be investigating that. That's one of the guys from Bravo Team from the intro, how they're talking about.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. No harm, no foul. So Spencer, which is someone who has mentioned previously about being the owner of this place, there's a file that we can find and we'll dick with it later. But they go on to explain how he hired like 17, something ridiculous, architectural companies to design this place and then would fire them after a part was done.
Okay. So that nobody knew.
So that way nobody knew and couldn't mess with anything. They wouldn't know the, they wouldn't understand the purpose. I don't remember the pattern. I think it was upright, downright, no. Upright, down left, across. It doesn't even matter, because I don't think I have any room. Solid. Alright, well, I fucked us super hard on that.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
But at least I know I can come in here and press the... Oh!
Oh, God.
Not today, fucker. I think if you get a headshot on him after you stick him with something, you can pick up that defense weapon again.
Oh.
Which is nice. Chris gets a grenade, and when you shoot, he puts it in their mouth, their head explodes. It's pretty cool.
That's pretty gross.
Oh, that dude did not die. Well, either way, it doesn't matter.
Is your mom okay?
Mom, what's up? Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's having to work on a mountainside. Alright, so... more items. So let's see. We'll go ahead and dump the healing item. We'll dump the sword key since we're never coming back for it. And we'll keep everything else. No, we'll dump the grenade launcher for right now too.
And the emblem. You need a death mask for what?
So remember where we got the sword key initially?
Mm-hmm.
And the back of that Book of Curses, you're gonna find out why. But we'll discover that next time. So let's go ahead and save, and we'll just call it here.
Okay.
Since it's almost close, but I also want to have time so that way you don't have to rush out of here to show you that horrible voice acting from the 90s.
Oh, I love horrible voice acting from the 90s. It's a very specific genre of a very specific thing that I like. From a very specific time.
It reminds us. It reminds me of how, like, I don't know. I mean, some parts were bad.
It was so wholesome.
Wholesome. There we go. We'll call it wholesome. What was it?
Buffy
the
Vampire. Which is a nice way of saying, oh, Buffy.
Buffy was pretty cheesy at times.
I love Buffy.
I did too. And I only like it because my dad...
Hands down. One
hands
of
down.
The...